Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Adam here for Rugby League Daily, and today I'm being brought by Leeds Rhinos player Shaun Lunt. Say hi, Shaun.
Hey, mate, you okay?
Yeah, cheers. So, we're going to be doing a little interview. So, first question, what got you interested in Rugby League?
It was my dad. He lived in Isle of Man when he was younger, and he played a lot of football and cricket as a kid. But then when he moved over and met my mum, he started playing rugby at the age of like 26, 27. And I think I was only probably about four at the time. But a couple of years later, my older brother Robert, he said to dad, oh, we want to play rugby now. Can we start a team off? So our local team. And my dad started rugby off in the town. And obviously, that's just how it sort of kicked on then. And then I was about six when I first played my first game. So, and then obviously just snowballed on from then. And so it was down to my dad. And it was down to my dad for a lot of other players as well for the town. So, yeah, we had a good little team.
That's good. So, what was your first memory as an amateur player or a professional player?
The first memory was before I actually played it, because I was watching my dad, and I was sat in the pram, and I was clobbered on the sideline, and a guy got tackled at the touch, and I was in my pram, and I got smoked. So that's probably one of my first ones amateur-wise. Playing amateur was probably just from my hometown club. Under-9s, we used to have the festivals and galas, and we were quite a good team, under-9s, actually, and we went on to win all the tournaments, which was really good, against like all the top amateur sides. And then professionally, my first one was, I think it was, what was it, 2006, I played against them. The first ever like adult game of professional rugby league was for Cumbria against an Anzac side, which was a mixed team of Australians and New Zealanders, and played against like Brett Cavalli, Marco Mealy, loads of top players. And I went to tackle Marco Mealy and I went a bit high, and he just put me right on my backside. So that's one of my first professional wise, and obviously from then I've just got more and more. So that's probably my first professional one.
That's good. Any role models and why?
Role models, as a kid, just my dad and my older brother. Obviously, your dad being your dad, he's always your hero as a kid, you know, someone who you look up to. And
yeah, that's nice.
My older brother, he's, I've always looked up to him. He's always given me the right advice and sort of always looked after me too. Sort of my oldest cousin, he was a footballer, played for Carlisle United, so we sort of had like a very sporty family. You know, I've got some of my cousins. One was a really good biker, and another one was a good rugby player. So I've been brought up in a real sporty family, to be honest. And I can always remember my cousin every time he used to come back to my life and survive. So love seeing that. So probably them three from role models growing up.
That's good. So what's been the best, obviously you're still playing at Leeds, but what's been the best career highlight for you at any team?
Oh, I've had some fantastic ones, you know. Yeah. From winning a grand final to playing for my country and getting to a Challenge Cup final. But for me, probably scoring a try at Wembley in my first Challenge Cup final in 2009. Obviously, winning the grand final and stuff like that was mega, and it's obviously right at the top. But for me, the previous year I played at Workington, and then 9 to 10 months later I'm playing in front of 70,000 people at Wembley and scoring a try. I'll never forget that feeling. Early on in the game, well, probably about 5 minutes early, I think it was, I got a try disallowed, so and then I was scored. Sort of them two together, and them two moments in a game, so yeah.
That's good. So, at the moment, as we've said, you're currently at Leeds and you played for Hull KR, Huddersfield, but what's been like the best club you've ever played for? Is like coach wise?
I played in some good, you know, some very, very good sides, and it's not, I wouldn't say it's, like, it's quite hard to say the best club because you go different seasons are different, you know, so
yeah.
It's all dependent on how you're going through the year. So obviously 2012 at Leeds was unbelievable because that was where I got my first trophy as a player. But then back at Huddersfield 2013, that was also brilliant because we won the league. And then 2017 at Hull Kingston, we got promoted again. So it's really hard to really say the best, you know, the best club, but probably on a whole, obviously it's got to be Leeds Rhinos because of what they've achieved. But for me personally, I don't look at clubs and stuff. I look at, you know, the actual how we perform on the field, because at the end of the day, that's what we get paid for as players, is to perform, and it's the results that matter at the end of the day. So, but yeah, all clubs, they've all treated me well, from work in Castleford to Huddersfield to OKR to Leeds. So, they've all been really good to me, and so I've not got a bad word to say about any club, to be honest.
That's good. So, on to the last question. How would you inspire kids if they wanted to be rugby league players? Like, what would you say to them?
Right, tough one, this, because rugby league's sort of a game that you fall in love with, well, any sport, really, because my youngest, he's a football... Well, sorry, my eldest and my two kids, he's massive on his football, so he absolutely loves football, so I don't think there's anything sort of I could say or... To inspire anyone to come and play rugby. But what I could do is give them advice, and just, there's going to be highs and there's going to be lows, so don't let the highs get you carried away with the sport, and don't let your lows, you know, take you away from the sport anyway, because like I say, a week in politics is a long time, but a week in rugby league could be just as long, I bet, because I can always remember in 2012 I was going through a really bad time at Huddersfield. I wasn't getting picked, and then I went to Leeds on the Monday training, played on the Friday against Catalan, scored a try, and literally within a week, like 5 days, literally in the hole, so my outlook on rugby changed again. So they say the good times are brilliant, but it's the tough times that you've got to keep persevering through, and knowing that it's going to be, you know, rainbow on the other side, so you just got to keep on going.
Okay, thank you very much for this, Shaun. Thank you very much. This has been Adam for Rugby League Daily, and bye.